السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. طلبة المرحلة الثالثة، اليوم حنكمل موضوع الماندبلر انستيزيا حتى باكر نكمله كليته بالميتينج. وصلنا إلى السبلمنتري انستيزيا. تكلمنا البارحة بالبارت 1 عن الانفيرال نيرف بلوك بالطريقتين مالته، الدايركت والاندايركت، اور الهالستد والاندايركت. وتكلمنا ايضا عن الجوجيتس تكنيك، وتكلمنا عن الاكينوزي بازيراني، وتكلمنا عن اللونج باكل نيرف انجكشن والمنتال والانسيزيف نيرف بلوك انستيزيا. وصلنا الى السبلمنتري انستيزيا اللي هي methods other than infiltration and regional block includes topical anesthesia, jet and injection, intrapapillary anesthesia, intraosseous anesthesia, intraligamentary, intraseptal, intrapalpal and transcutaneous electronic nerve stimulation. Topical anesthesia سبق وتكلمنا عليه. A topical anesthetic may achieve beneficial effects prior to needle penetration. Such effects may be psychological or pharmacological. Factors that influence the pharmacological efficacy of topical anesthetic including the agent employed, نوعية الدواء المستعمل, duration of application and site of application. The transfer of anesthetic through the mucosa is concentration dependent. قد ما تعطي كمية أكثر من التوبيكال أنستيزيا يزيد ما حيكون دخول والديسولفنت of such anesthesia is more. The agent usually different delivery vehicles are used to administer topical anesthetics. These include aerosols, ointment, gels, paste, powders and solutions. Most used هو الointment والspray type. Aside, the effectiveness of topical anesthesia varies in different parts of mouth. ممكن نستعمل بالmandibular buccal fold, maxillary buccal fold, palatal mucosa. And the best is used in infiltration and regional block injection. Some reductions in the response of dental pulps to electrical stimulation have been reported following application of topical anesthesia to the overlying anesthesia. من الممكن أحيانا يسوي لك pulpal anesthesia، لكن الحقيقة الواقع العملي يثبت غير ذلك. النوعية الثانية من التكنيك الممكن نستعملها whether in mandible or in maxilla هي الجت injections. الجت injections works by forcing anesthetic solution through mucosa under pressure، واللي هاي تكلمنا عنها بالtype of syringes بالمحاضرة السابقة. Some devices accept dental local anesthetic cartridges. With others, the solution has to be drawn up into a reservoir in the injector. يحطون الكاربولة وهاي you will inject it by pressure, not by needle, through the mucosa and will give infiltration of the tooth of interest or tooth to be treated. The effectiveness. The technique has been shown to provide enough anesthesia in some cases to allow extraction of teeth. On the other hand, it is not 100% effective in reducing injection discomfort of the needle penetration after surface anesthesia with jet injection. The efficacy is dependent upon the concentration of local anesthetic solution used. A disadvantage هو occasionally hematoma because of the pressure, spillage of anesthetic solution into the mouth. يعني يبدي خرخر الانستيزيا بالماوث وهذا يضيف unpleasant taste. النوع الآخر من التكنيك الممكن نعطيها هي الانترابابيلاري انستيزيا. الانترابابيلاري انستيزيا هو localized anesthesia and hemorrhage control during periodontal surgery. نعطي بالانترابابيلاري وهاي عادة نعطيها للبريوسيرجري، نعطيها من دا تسوي filling ويصير bleeding فتعطي injection to reduce with vasoconstrictor طبعا to reduce bleeding. باليت أيضا نعطي بالباليتال انستيزيا following buccal infiltration. It is particularly useful in children. The needle is inserted at the buccal aspect of papilla at site about 2 mm apical to the tip of the papilla is ideal. جوا البابيلا ننزل في 2 mm and we inject it there. The needle parallel to the occlusal plane and the solution injected slowly. Blanching of the papilla indicates successful deposition. من تبيض البابيلا معناه ده يدخل انستيزيا وبفعل البيزو كونستريكتر يسوي لك whitening of the tissue. النوع الثاني او الاخر من التكنيك اوف انستيزيا هو intraosseous anesthesia. اذا deposition of the anesthetic solution directly into the cancellous space. رأسا انت الهدف هنا احنا دائما نطي هنا بالانفلتريشن. هنا لا انت حتحفر بالعظم and you will give the anesthesia directly into the cancellous bone. The technique may be performed with conventional dental local anesthetic delivery system. However, the introduction of specialized equipment has made this method easier to carry out. The point of penetration is identified. It should lie in the attached gingiva. Is determined by an imagining of two lines perpendicular to one another. خطين متعامدين على بعض. The horizontal line passes along the buccal gingival margins of teeth with gingival sulcus and the vertical line bisects the distal interdental papilla of the tooth that's being anesthetized. The distal interdental papilla. The site of perforation is 2 mm apical to the intersection of these lines. 2 mm apical, يعني below تقاطع هذين الخطين. The area of perforation is infiltrated with 0.2 ml of local anesthetic. The perforator is used 1 minute later when the gingival anesthesia has occurred. When using the specialized equipment, the perforator, يعني المثقاب, is advanced through the anesthetized gingiva and bone using a slow speed handpiece. Following removal of the perforator, the short 6 mm 27 gauge needle is inserted through the perforation into the cancellous bone. About 1 ml of solution is delivered and حدود سن أو أحيانا سنين يعني تحتاج 0.5 مليليتر للسن أو سنين or even a carpool for multiple teeth to be perforated to be treated. This technique should be avoided in cases of ما نقدر نستعمل في حالات periodontitis, limited attached gingiva, little interradicular bone. The duration and the spread of anesthesia, the onset of intraosseous anesthesia is rapid لأنه مباشرة حينزل على بالcancellous bone ويكون very close to the nerve fibers ranging from 10 إلى دقيقتين. The success falls off rapidly over an hour and the decline in anesthesia seems to be more rapid in the anterior teeth. Advantages of the intraosseous anesthesia. How smaller dose is required, smaller area of soft tissue anesthesia is produced, and the methods aids in overcoming the failure of conventional technique. Disadvantages مالته, technically more difficult. تخيل انت تصرف عظم مراجع ما يتقبلها بسهولة. Specialized equipment may be needed. Systemic effects may be increased. Post-injection discomfort. Yeah, I am she. The post-injection discomfort may be produced. والتيث may be damaged. إذا واحد ما مضبط أموره زين ممكن يضرب الروت or periodontal ligament، وهالمرة هو دا يطيل أنستيزيا حيبدي يتحلحل السن مع المراجع. Intraosseous anesthesia necessitated the use of a half round bear to provide an entry into the interseptal bone that had been surgically exposed. Once the hole had been made, a needle would be inserted into this hole and local anesthesia is deposited. نستعملون عادة هاي النيدل اللي بيها ستوبر أو شورت نيدل ممكن واحد يستعملها. السيستم اسمه الستابيدنت سيستم consists of two parts: the perforator, a bar that perforates the cortical plate of bone with a conventional slow speed contra angle handpiece, and an 8 millimeter long 27 gauge needle is inserted into the pre-drilled hole for anesthetic administration. Intrafall HTP anesthetic delivery system, هاي سيستم آخر أيضا هالاسم هذا, was introduced combining the two steps to perform intraosseous anesthesia. هاي الهاندبيس مالته وحتى قسم عدا وياها مي, يعني شلون التوربين إذا بمي نفس الشيء to reduce heating during working. هذا بالستوبر مال نيدل حتى لا تفوت زايد بالني بدي بيها مثل الستوبر حتى يحدد اذا تستعمل لونج نيدل يحددك ايش قد تدخل بالنيدل. هذا الستوبر مالتها, هذا هو الانترا اوسياس انستيزيا. النوع الاخر من التكنيك اللي ممكن نستعمله سبلمنتري ان اديشن للبلوك انجكشن هو الانترا ليجامنتالي اور بيريودنتال ليجامنت انستيزيا, وهذا سبق شفناه ويعني تكلمنا عن السرنج مالته والطلاب اللي حضروا المختبر ايضا شافوا السرنج مالته. The solution is injected via periodontal ligament reaching the palpal nerve supply by entering the cancellous bone via perforations in the socket wall, not by traveling down the length of the ligament. The potential benefit of periodontal injection lies in the fact that it provides palpal and soft tissue anesthesia in a localized area, اللي هو usually a single tooth, of the mandible without producing extensive soft tissue anesthesia. طبعا على الحقيقة أنا periodontal injection أحترمها كل شوية, لكن أحترمها ويعجبني دائما أعطيها للمراجع after giving block injection. أحيانا تطي block injection والمراجع يظل يحس بألم, طبعا بالإكستراكشن هذا دا أقصد, فلا بأس أنه تطي periodontal injection very very effective, وتطي لك بالذات لما أنت تقرأ السن بخمس دقائق أقل عشر دقائق ينقلع كلش تريحك بالقلع ويا البيشنت. ها هي الانجكشن, periodontal injection or pressure injection or intraligamental injection. A duration and spread of intraligamentary anesthesia. The duration of intraligamentary anesthesia between individuals is marked. The duration of reliable palpal anesthesia is around 15 minutes for a single rooted tooth and rather less for molars. Intraligamentary anesthesia is not a single tooth anesthetic. Spread of anesthesia to the adjacent teeth occurs with both specialized and conventional syringes, but appears to happen more frequently with the former type. The technique. It is recommended that the site of penetration is swabbed with an antiseptic solution, although the syringe can be performed using either the conventional or specialized syringes. A 30 gauge needle is recommended. The needle is inserted into the mesiobuccal aspect of the root at 30 degree to the long angle of the or long axis of the tooth. A needle, so the needle is inserted بزاوية 30 درجة with the long axis of the tooth. The needle is advanced to a maximum penetration until it is wedged. يعني تحسها انعوجت حتى تحسها شوية انعوجت وتكون محصورة between the tooth and the alveolar crest. إذا ظل تدوس بها زايد ما يطلع انستيزيا يعني نوبات اكو فت بارتيكلز تفوت بيها اور ايفن الفود دبريز الموجود بالسالكس ما يطلع نوبات انستيزيا. Once the needle is correctly positioned, the solution is injected under back pressure. It is recommended that 0.2 ml of the solution is deposited. And when using the specialized syringe, the needle should remain in position for about 10 seconds following the depression of the lever to allow escape of solution from the cartridge. ها هي الصور for periodontal injection. بالنسبة للمولر ريجن تطي على عدد الروتات الموجودة بي. There are two important indicators of success of injection. Significant resistance to the deposition of local anesthetic solution. Ischemia of soft tissue adjacent to the injection site. Where if the tooth is multi-rooted, remove the needle and repeat the procedure on the other root or roots. Advantages of the intraligamentary anesthesia. Smaller doses required. Rapid onset of anesthesia. The method aids in overcoming failure of conventional technique. Small area of soft tissue is anesthetized. It's useful in the mandible for patient with bleeding dietitians. And its use as possible aid in diagnosis. أحيانا تفيدك بالacute pain of patients. Disadvantages, the production of bacteremia, increased systemic effects, pre and post injection discomfort, damage to the dental periodontal tissues can be caused, damage equipment, لأنه بعد تندقم النيدل أثناء دخولها بالperiodontal sulcus. Contraindication of periodontal injection هو infection or severe inflammation at the injection site or presence of primary teeth. ليش presence of primary teeth؟ إيش راح يصير هنا؟ هذا سؤال لكم تونسوا به. الأذر تكنيك هو الانتراسبتال أنستيزيا. A hybrid of intraligamentary and intraosseous anesthesia. هو جمع بين الانتراليجامنتري والانتراوسيوس انستيزيا. The effect is identical to the intraligamentary injection. A short 27 gauge needle is inserted into the buccal interdental papilla, injecting while it is directed toward the bone. Once the bone is contacted, the needle is advanced into the bone and 0.2 ml of solution is injected. The technique may be used instead of intraligamentary anesthesia if the periodontal condition is poor. وهي هي صورته لل intrasubtal anesthesia. Area of insertion with target area, both are the center of the interdental papilla adjacent to the tooth to be treated. The bevel facing the apex of the tooth. الانترابالبال انستيزيا هذا عادة نستعمله بالاندودونتيك تريتمنت بحالات حشوات الجذور. The technique, this method of anesthesia relies on deposition of solution directly into the palpal canals. Usually it will be administered following the injection of anesthetic solution by another route. طبعا انت بنطي بلوك لكن يظل المراجع يتألم فمن الممكن you give it intrapalpal injection. It is essential that the solution is injected into the pulp under pressure. Fit is tight either by opening a small round bore into the pulp chamber or if it not can be done by inserting the needle deep to the canal. 0.2 ml of anesthesia is required to be injected. The intrapulmonary injection provides pain control through both pharmacological action of the local anesthetic and applied pressure بالضغط على العصب. This technique may be used once the pulp chamber is exposed surgically or pathologically. Indication when pain control is necessary for pulp extirpation or other endodontic treatment in the absence of adequate anesthesia from other technique. Ideally, wedge the needle firmly into the pulp chamber or root canal. Instrumentation may begin approximately 30 seconds after administration of anesthesia into the pulp. The advantages of intrapulmonary anesthesia: success is independent of the solution. The methods aids in overcoming failed conventional methods. Single tooth anesthesia may be obtained. There are minimal systemic effects. Disadvantages: discomfort may be produced. Application of the method is limited. هي محددة هاي الطريقة just للpulp of the tooth to be treated. إلى هنا تنتهي محاضرتنا حول الماكسيلار الماندبلار انستيزيا وتوابعها، ونلتقي إن شاء الله يوم الأحد بالميتينج. وشكرا جزيلا وبارك الله بكم.